President's assent to the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023 was announced by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among. She also said five other bills which were passed recently had been signed into law. The anti-gay bill was first passed by Parliament in March and was returned in April for reconsideration, especially on some clauses which needed clarity. It was passed again in early May with reforms. The anti-gay bill was moved by the Bujiri Municipality MP Asuman Basalirwa. Now law, it will see anyone engaging in acts of homosexuality facing 20 years in jail, while a death penalty awaits anyone engaging in aggravated homosexuality.
I want to particularly thank the Speaker for giving me and my colleagues a platform to present this bill before Parliament. I want to thank my colleagues on the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee. I want to thank all the stakeholders, people who came to the committee to give their views.
The provisions embedded in the law seek to protect the traditional family by prohibiting any form of sexual relations between persons of the same sex and promotion of such acts. It also seeks to address the gaps of other laws in Uganda, including the Penal Code Act, Cap 120, as well as supplement provisions of the Constitution by criminalizing same-sex acts.
What was a bill is now an act of Parliament called the Anti-Homosexuality Act 2023. It was assented to by the President and forwarded to Parliament.
The law slaps a penalty of 1 billion shillings on a legal entity convicted of promoting homosexuality, whereas an attempt to perform the act attracts a 7-year prison term.
You commit an offense under this act. So the operational word here is knowingly. Now the question is, how do I get to know? It's a question of evidence. You could be told. You could be told. If a group of people come to you and openly tell you, we are going to engage in these acts, then you have known. So if you have veiled the premises, then definitely you are breaching this law.
The law provides for 3-year imprisonment of a child convicted of the act of homosexuality, which is in line with Section 94, Clause 1G of the Children Act, Cap 120.
Child offenders don't suffer the same penalties like adult offenders. Under this law, when a child offender, when somebody is convicted of acts of homosexuality, the maximum sentence is 3 years.
Persons who knowingly allow their premises to be used for acts of homosexuality face 7 years in jail upon conviction, while those who fail to report acts of homosexuality on children and vulnerable persons while having knowledge about them face a fine of 10 million shillings or 5 years in jail.
Homosexuality is limited to two incidents. One, if you get to know that a child has been a victim of homosexuality and you don't report, or if you get to know that a vulnerable person has been a victim of homosexuality and you don't report, you commit an offense.
The mover of the bill, Asuman Basalirwa, who addressed the press shortly after the news of assent to law, clarified on a number of issues.
Optical observation. Then obviously circumstances. Because in law, we even talk about circumstantial evidence. So it's also important to highlight this because it is one of those things that has been a subject of distortion. So the operational word on the premises is knowingly. So I thought that should also be highlighted.
Basalirwa vowed to fight at all fronts to ensure that the law is not thwarted by the courts of law, like what happened to the first anti-gay bill that was enacted by the 9th Parliament and nullified by the Constitutional Court on grounds it lacked quorum.
I support anybody who wants to go to court over this aspect, but they will find us there, definitely. We will also be in court.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.